Make no mistake, these funds will help many people across our state who are really, really hurting now.
Providing emergency food and basic supplies, offering interim housing and shelter to those who need it, expanding primary health care services, assisting with utility costs and other financial burdens, and supporting children and families who are.
The governor today also said his disaster declaration for the state has been approved by the federal government. That will allow more dollars to flow into the state and FEMA to come in and help, as well as additional help for those that find themselves out of a job. Senator Durbin joined the governor today to update everyone on what happened last night to pass legislation in the Senate to help hospitals and workers get through this pandemic. Legislation that still needs to be passed by the House and signed by the president. The governor, as well as the state's top doctor, chastised those who are still not following the stay-at-home order. They say the virus doesn't care if you are bored. The virus doesn't care how old you are. The stay-at-home order, they say, has been put in place to not only save your life, but others as well.
But we need to look forward and look for the big picture. There's a lot at stake, and we can't go for short-term wins at the cost of our society. Let us not grow weary in well-doing. Let's stay strong and stay the course. It's the only way we can stop the spread of COVID-19.
Now, the governor also commented today on a letter that President Trump sent to all the governors across the country here, basically some guidance on how to open up parts of the country that aren't seeing as many COVID-19 cases as others. The governor, when asked about that today, he said that he is really concerned about that. He says we really need to follow the science here because this could lead to more deaths.